Morning, students. Is my voice audible? Are you able to see the presentation?
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Okay, good morning. Thank you. So we'll continue with our discussion on unit 3. So yesterday we have finished about JFET. So in unit 3 is about field effect transistor, the family of FET. And in that we have two exclusive divisions in that FET family. One is JFET, junction field effect transistor, which we have seen till yesterday, and it is called junction field effect because we have two PN junctions, correct? The second important category is MOSFET, the expansion for MOSFET, see metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. So the name indicates you have three layers. First one, you have a metal layer. Under the metal layer, you have an oxide layer. Under the oxide layer, you have a semiconductor layer. Oxide means it is silicon dioxide, SiO2. Okay, so this arrangement of this device gives it the name MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. MOSFET is previously they were calling this device to be IGFET, insulated gate field effect transistor. Then they renamed it to MOSFET, and MOSFET has become very popular. And wherever you use MOSFET or IGFET, the meaning is going to be same. So don't think they are different. It was initially named as IGFET and then it was renamed to MOSFET, which became popular. And to just like how in JFET you have N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET, in MOSFET also you have two categories. One is called as enhancement MOSFET and another one is called as depletion MOSFET. So this is not based on N or P-type. This enhancement and depletion is having their own logic. Okay, and you see this is the FET. This is the MOSFET device. You see here, I think you are able to see the construction of N-channel enhancement MOSFET. So you see a metal layer here. So you see an aluminium layer, metal. And below the metal, you have an oxide layer, SiO2. And below the oxide, you have the semiconductor. So that is why the name metal oxide semiconductor MOS. Okay, so from top to bottom, first you have a metal layer, and from the metal you will be taking the connection for gate. Okay, and then you have a silicon dioxide layer immediately below the metal, and immediately below the SiO2 you have your semiconductor layer. So you have a p-type substrate you take, and in that you grow two n plus regions for source and drain. N indicates your normal N region where the majority carriers are going to be electrons, and N plus indicates it's a heavily doped N-type region. Okay, N plus indicates a heavily doped N plus region. And you have a channel formed between the two N plus regions, so it is called as an N-channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay, in p-type substrate you had two n plus layers below the SiO2 layer, and channel is formed between the two n plus regions, so it is called as n channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay, and in JFET we have seen the gate voltage has to be negative and VDS has to be positive, right? In n channel JFET, VGS has to be negative and VDS has to be positive. In p-channel JFET it is the reverse. VGS has to be positive and VDS has to be negative. But here in MOSFET, that restriction is not there. The gate voltage can vary from, it can be negative or positive or zero. It can take any of the conditions. Okay. And for N-channel JFET, the gate voltage is positive. Okay. Remember, for N-channel JFET or N-channel enhancement MOSFET, for this N-channel enhancement MOSFET, the gate voltage is positive. VDS is also positive. See, I told you gate, rendu gate irukum. So topmost metal layer is also a gate. The bottom mode substrate is also a gate. So we are short circuiting both and giving a positive supply to gate. And you know VDS is positive. So drain is positive, source is negative. Okay, this is the voltage connection for your N-channel enhancement MOSFET. And this is the circuit diagram. You have a broken line to differentiate this from JFET. Okay, and if the arrow mark is flowing inwards, means it is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. If the arrow mark is flowing outwards, means you have P-channel enhancement MOSFET. See, broadly, it is classified into enhancement and depletion. Enhancementally, you have N-channel and P-channel. Depletionally, you have N-channel and P-channel. Okay, so that is how it is subclassified into. So what I am doing, I am going to apply an electric field across the semiconductor material. So because of applying the electric field, what happens? I am going to form a channel, And the thickness of the channel can be controlled by applying the electric field. So that is why the device is called as a field effect transistor. The electric field is going to control the thickness of your channel. So in depletion MOSFET, what happens? The electric field will reduce the number of majority carriers. In enhancement MOSFET, it is going to increase the number of majority carriers. Okay, majority carriers can be electrons on holes, that we are not worried about. But remember, in depletion MOSFET, because of the supplied electric field, depletion nalae ungalukku theriyum, something is getting reduced or something is getting diminished, right? So depletion MOSFET means the whatever electric field you are going to apply across the device, it is going to reduce the number of majority carriers. These majority carriers can be electrons or holes. Okay. In enhancement MOSFET, the same electric field will increase the number of majority carriers. That majority carrier same way can be electrons or holes. Okay. This is the operating basic theory about enhancement and depletion MOSFET. See, ideally, the electrons will flow from source to drain. So actual current will flow from drain to source. Current direction ID paranga, it is the conventional current flow. But actual direction of electronic flow, current flow will happen from source to drain. You know, source is the just like your emitter, and drain is just like your collector. So source will emit your majority carriers and drain will collect your majority carriers. Either way, P-channel enhancement MOSFET on the substrate will be N-type. Yeah, you will be having P plus here, and the channel will be formed between the two P plus regions. The construction alone will change. And remember, it is MOSFET, so definitely you will have three layers. Uppermost metal layer, usually made of aluminium. Below the metal layer, you will have silicon dioxide. And below that, you will have your semiconductor device, where you locate your terminal source and drain and your channel. Okay. So the construction is, we are going to study about enhancement MOSFET. So the application of electric field is going to increase the majority carrier concentration. The construction, you know, you are going to take a P-type substrate. You are going to etch 2N plus highly doped N plus regions in the P-type substrate. Above this, you are going to grow a layer of silicon dioxide. Above which, you are going to grow a layer of metal. From the metal, it is going to be the gate connection. And from the two N plus terminals, you are going to take the connection for source and drain. Okay, that is the construction of N-channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay. See, there is no continuous channel in enhancement MOSFET. So that is why they have given the line is broken here. The channel is not continuous. It is just like it is broken. Okay. So the channel is not continuous. So enhancement MOSFET, the symbol will be this. Depletion MOSFET, we'll have a separate symbol. This one is enhancement MOSFET symbol, where you have three broken lines. And if the arrow mark is flowing inwards, it is going to be your N channel. And if the arrow mark is flowing outwards, it's going to be your P channel. And you know it has terminals gate, drain, and source. And additionally, you will have one more terminal, substrate. Substrate is just like the second gate. And you see here, both the gates are shorted, right? So it is shorted. Between the gates, I'm going to give a supply VGG. Okay. So this is your enhancement MOSFET. And you can see here two highly doped N plus regions are diffused in the P-type substrate. The one region is going to be called as the source. One region, other region is going to be called as a drain. They are separated by 1 mL or 1 milli inch. Okay. The milli inch, it is called as mL in standard unit. So separated by 1 × 10⁻³ inch. So above your N plus regions, you are going to grow SiO2 layer. So that is called as your oxide layer, allowing the contact for source and drain. So above the SiO2 layer, I'm going to grow a layer of aluminium. So metal, oxide, semiconductor. Okay. So metal layer covers the entire channel, and from the, it forms the gate. From the metal, whatever connection you are going to take, it is going to be the gate connection. And you can see here, you can see the diagram. You have the metal layer, and you have the oxide layer, and then you have the semiconductor layer. So it is just looking like a parallel plate capacitor. Two plates are there. One is metal, one is semiconductor. In between, you are going to have an insulator. So this gives rise to what is called as parallel plate capacitor, parallel plate capacitive effect. Okay, that is what is given here. You can see. So the metal area of the gate in with an insulating oxide layer and the semiconductor forms a parallel plate capacitor. You know, a capacitor will look like this, right? So you have two parallel plates, So one parallel plate is metal, one parallel plate is semiconductor, and in between the two you will have an insulator. Usually you will have air as an insulator, but here you are going to have the oxide layer as an insulator. So this is just giving rise to what is called as an capacitive effect because of this arrangement of metal oxide and semiconductor. And the device is also called, you know, it is called as IG FET because the SiO2 layer is bare. SiO2 is an insulator. So the between the gate and the semiconductor, there is no connection. You have an SiO2 insulating layer, right? That is why this IG FET name has come for this MOSFET. So the gate is insulated by the SiO2 layer. So it is called as insulated gate field effect transistor. I again repeat, IG FET and MOSFET are all same terminologies. Previously, it was called as IG FET and now it has been predominantly called as MOSFET for convenience. Okay, so now the operation. So any doubt in the construction of MOSFET, anybody is having doubt, please feel free to ask any doubts if you have. See, you should relate and study BJT, FET, MOSFET. If you relate and study, then you can understand which device is different in what aspect. Otherwise, it is going to be difficult for you. Okay, please relate and study all the transistor models. Now the operation. So see here, I am going to ground my substrate and I am going to apply a positive voltage in the gate. So see here, I am going to apply a positive voltage in the gate. So the metal layer will be completely having positive charge. Okay, so simple, very important thing. Please listen here. I am going to give a positive voltage to gate. So since you have a positive, you're connecting the positive terminal of battery to the gate, the metal layer will be having a lot of positive ions because of this positive terminal. So positive charges will be formed in the metal layer. And you know SiO2 will act like an insulator, right? So what happens, this insulator, this will induce an equal and opposite charge, which is the negative charge between the source and drain regions. So this SiO2 will induce equal and opposite charge. So here I have positive charge. So it will induce negative charge between the source and drain terminals. Or I can say it will induce negative charge. If you have a lot of positive charge, it is going to be holes, right? So if you have a lot of holes in the gate region, in between the regions where you have a channel between the source and drain, you will have a lot of electrons. And it happens because of capacitive effect. You know, in capacitance, if one plate has lot of one plate, you give positive charge, the other plate will automatically be negative charge, and a strong electric field is set up between the two plates. So in between the two regions, you have a strong electric field set up in the SiO2 layer. This SiO2 layer will have a strong electric field set up, it will set up a strong electric field between the gate and the semiconductor terminals. So very, very important to understand, if I'm going to give a positive supply to the gate, I have positive charges induced because of capacitive effect by the SiO2 insulating layer. It induces an equal and opposite charge on the other side of the SiO2, which is going to be in the semiconductor region. So between the two N plus regions of source and drain, you will be having a lot of negative charges. So please understand till this, that is what is given here. So because of the capacitive effect, you see here, you have an equal negative charge induced on the substrate side between the source and drain regions. So you have an electric field produced because of this. So this direction of electric field is perpendicular to the plate of the capacitance to the metal oxide. So you have an electric field present between the source and drain in the form of a channel. So the negative charge of the electrons, which are minority carriers in p-type, forms the inversion layer. So as the positive voltage on the gate increases, the induced negative charge on semiconductor also increases. So more and more positive voltage you apply to VGG, you have a lot of electrons formed between the two N plus regions. You know this is a fully p-channel substrate. P-channel substrate, it is containing a lot of holes. The p-channel substrate, electrons are going to be minority in number, but how can I increase the number of electrons by applying more voltage to the gate terminal? By applying a very high voltage to the gate terminal, I am producing more number of electrons between the two N plus regions. One N plus region is going to be your source, one N plus region is going to be your drain. Okay, so when you have more number of electrons, you have conductive current will start to flow from source to drain through the channel, and that is going to constitute a drain current. And in edanal enhancement solrom, because I am increasing the number of electrons by applying a more and more positive voltage to the gate. And see here, if I apply 1 volt to the gate, my drain current is this much. If I apply 2 volt to the gate, see the drain current is increasing. So if I apply 3 volt to the gate, my drain current is even more increasing. So my in the enhancement condition, my gate voltage will be positive. A positive gate voltage will induce more drain current into my device. Any doubt in the operation of enhancement MOSFET? Please, you have to understand these things very, very clearly. And there is, you cannot draw these graphs blindly. There are this graph, whatever is drawn, has a lot of significance. I'm going to pause for a few seconds. Please recollect any doubt if you have and ask me. Can anybody say what will be the changes for enhancement p-channel MOSFET? This is whatever we have seen as enhancement n-channel MOSFET, right? So if I'm going to use an enhancement p-channel MOSFET, what will be the change in the circuit, in the construction, other things, what will be the change? Can anybody say? It is going to be completely opposite, right? So if I'm going to use a p-type substrate, what will be I be using now? What will be I using now for p-channel enhancement MOSFET? I'll be using a what substrate? I'll be using
n-type substrate.
N-type substrate. It is going to be opposite. So in n-type substrate, I'll be inducing 2p plus regions. 2p plus regions. Okay, and you have a channel formed between the two p plus regions. Otherwise the gate, the silicon dioxide, other things are going to be the same. They are going to be the same, except that other things are going to be the same. I'm going to change the concentration of the substrate, and the n plus will become p plus, the p type substrate will become n type substrate. So you will get the same. And in n-channel enhancement MOSFET, you have a lot of production of electrons between the two n plus regions. In p-channel enhancement MOSFET, you will have a lot of production of holes. So your gate voltage will be negative. Only if you give gate voltage negative, you will have negative charge here, and you will produce a lot of positive charge here. The more and more negative you make your gate voltage, the more and more positive charges are produced here, which is going to be producing the enhancement MOSFET. So understand, in exam we will be dealing only with n channel. If they ask p channel, it is not like out of question or you don't know. You have to, with the concept of n channel, you have to write the same logic for p channel, and you have to explain the graph and other things as it is. Okay, and depletion MOSFET graphs, we will see it later, because we have not seen the depletion MOSFET construction and working, right? So for enhancement MOSFET, please understand VGS is positive. Jay Fetler, we have seen the gate voltage is negative, but here VGS is going to be positive for enhancement MOSFET. That is the one major difference you have to understand between Jay Fetler and enhancement MOSFET.